Okay, everybody. If you're stretching at home, remember to take like a minute to at least warm your body up, whether that be some planks, high knees, butt kicks, jumping jacks, all are great options. Yeah. We're going to start with your hips wall, hips floor, your choice, how you would like to do this. As you set up into it, you don't need a yoga block. You're going to take one knee, set it close to the wall. Your knee is in between your hands, the one that's coming forward. And then you're going to rotate your foot outwards like two or three little fingers, yes? You want to hollow all the way, especially through that lower spine, so you're starting to feel this in your hip flexors. And all the way up, you can take your eyeballs to your belly button. That's a great option. Making sure you're breathing through this stretch. You can rock side to side. You want to do the same amount each direction, so make sure you're not favoring one over the other. Then you can take the foot that's against the wall and turn it in so your foot's directly behind you. Same thing, you can move through the stretch at any point. You can massage anything that you may need. Remember keeping that hollow position. Breathing through all of it, sinking through all of it. Then you're going to take your toe, rotate it out. So now it should be kind of more behind your shoulder. Same idea, hollow position. You can rock through it as you would like. Eyeballs to your belly button. Good, then you're going to go ahead using the same arm as leg, right behind. This is the tricky part. You want to keep your hollow position the whole time. And grab your foot, and you're just going to shake it a little bit. Give it a nice shake out. Tell your body to relax. You're breathing, curling through your spine. And put it back at the wall. Take a moment. One more. Reset your body. Oh my gosh, I did the dance to this.
Oh my gosh, you did.
And I was like in third grade. And relax. Good. We'll go into your other leg. Same setup. Everybody has those days. Again, knee between your hands, rotating it out a little bit. You should have two or three fingers. And curving through your spine using your hollow position. It might be crazy, I do it anyway. Good breathing. Curling that lumbar spine especially. You can rock side to side. And put that foot behind you more, turning it in. And then you're going to use your foot and take it outside, following out, rocking side to side. And wrapping behind, grabbing the same foot as arm, giving it a shake, keeping your hollow position. That's the most important part. Curling through your spine. And you can put it back down. Breathing. And relax. Nice dancers. Okay, we're going into your squaring exercise next. So now you're going to face the mirror or face your wall. One leg is extended. It doesn't have to be touching the floor. On your other one, it's kind of like your jazz foot, yes? Knee all the way up against the wall. You should feel that as you're facing the wall with your chest, your hips are not square. Not muscling through this position at all. You're going to just rotate as you start to feel your glutes or your core. engaged, you're just telling them to turn off. And then you're going back to neutral. Again, not using anything, you open through it. You should feel a stretch in that bent hip flexor. And back to neutral. We'll do it about four times. Rotate through. Try not to use any muscles to do so. Relaxing them. And last one, take your body over. Hold it for a minute. And then you can reach your hands to the outside of your extended knees. Now you'll feel a hammy stretch a little bit more. You can take your elbows to the floor if you would like. You can keep your arms extended. Anything's okay. Good. Coming back on up. And rotating. Relax. Other side, dancers. Again, extending one leg. Taking your other knee to the wall. Starting with your chest facing the wall, you're going to rotate and open through your hip, not muscling any of it. It's okay if that hip is off the floor. And back to neutral. And squaring. Good. Relax. Same idea, breathing through the whole exercise and rotating your hips. Trying to pull them nice and square to the leg in front of you. And down. One more time. Rotate. We're going to take your arms down and across your body, wherever you are today. This isn't a stretch for your spine, it's for your legs. Good. And coming back on up. Relax. You can let your knees fall in if you would like. You should feel a stretch on the outside of your legs. Outside of your booty a little bit. And then we'll go back into an external position. Nice little rotation. Taking a yoga block, a brick, a something, something, something. You'll put that against the wall. We're going into your straddle stretch. You're going to set up with your foot or ankle against the brick. Sit nice and tall. You should be on your sit bones. You're telling your muscles to relax. Anywhere that you may feel tension, you can start massaging or vibrating. And then we're going to go ahead, using light pressure, you will rotate your knee outward. And then same thing, you're going to take it, press in the outside of your knee, rotate your leg inward. You shouldn't feel as much movement this way. Your hips lock out a little bit faster, turning it in. Good, same thing, rotating it out. Anywhere that you might tense up, remember to shake it out, massage it out. And one more, rotating open. And up. And rotating in. Good, and relax. feel how that leg sits a little bit deeper into the floor, a little more relaxed through your hip. You can rotate, adjust, other side, set up with your yoga block. Rotate up, eyeballs up. We're going to take three plies in this position. We have Then same thing, three plies, plie one, and stretch, plie two, and stretch, plie three, and stretch. Eyeballs forward, you choose open or closed position. I think I'm going to go open. And then you can just do little chest isolations, rock side to side. Just little mini movements. Good, let's rotate other side. Be gentle to yourself. Check out how one arm is longer than the other. And then pull up. Same thing, thumb up, rotating away from the mirror. Wherever is comfortable for you, it might be different every day. Shoulder down, eyeballs down. Shoulder up, eyeballs up. Shoulder down, eyeballs down. Shoulders up, eyeballs up. Shoulders down, eyeballs down. Good. Let's take some plies. We have three of them. And plie. And stretch again. Plie. And stretch again. Plie. And stretch. Very nice. Eyeballs down, shoulders down. Three plies. Same thing. And up. And up. Close your open position. Add little micro movements side to side. And relax. Come out of it nice and slow. The last one we'll do, if you want to grab your little mat, because we at home you may have carpet, but if we don't. We're going to go ahead. And you're going to go onto your three cornered, or roll over your toes. Your goal is to get your first knuckles onto the floor. And then you're going to rest your knee on the mirror. Yeah? Whenever we're doing your toe or ankle stretches, you want to think about lifting up through your heel, not sinking down into the floor. And all we're going to do is you can rock your body back a little bit. And rocking forward. And rocking back. Bless you, Ham Bam. And back to the wall. One more away. And down. Good. You're going to move your foot just a little closer to the wall. See if you can feel it a little bit higher in your ankle. Always welcome to take a plie here if you would like. And now we're going to extend this front leg. So you're going to try and push through your knee. Your goal is to try and keep those first knuckles down. It may feel like your toes are being crunchy. That's okay. They're not necessarily long in this exercise. Bring your knee back to the mirror. And then you're going to extend again, straightening nice and slow. And bring it on back nice and slow. Be kind to it. Remember, you're lifting up and out through your heel. Last one. And extend. And bring it on back. Nice. Relax. Come out of there slowly. Take a plie. Shake it out if you would like. And then we'll do your other foot. Again, setting up over the top of your first knuckles. You can put your knee on the mirror or on your wall. Hanging out a little bit, pulling up and out, not down and in. We're gonna rock back with your knee away from the mirror, still bent. And bring it up over and through, back to the mirror. And bring it back. And push it forward. Last one away. And bring it back. Now you're going to move your foot a little bit closer to the wall. Pulling up and out. you're going to pull your knee away. Now you're going to try and extend it. You'll feel this through the top of your foot, at the top of your ankle a little bit. And bend your knee nice and slow, back to the mirror. And extend. You'll feel like your toes are a little crunchy. That's okay. And extend one more time through your knee. And back over the top. Be gentle as you come out of this. And relax, everybody. You can always throw in any other stretches that we do in class. Nice work.